Our story begins when I ran into Robbie Williams, Heidi Klum, and the remaining members of Fifth Harmony at the Dolce & Gabbana Spring Show.
Hate him, loathe her, over them, cancel it, tell me everything.
You know, one of my shyest friends, I won't say his name to preserve his privacy, but he found my presence so comforting that he asked me to co-host his TV show, Anderson Cooper 360. I am an expert at mediating conflict, like when my friend Scary, Sporty, Posh and Baby had an issue with my other friend, Archbishop Desmond Tutu.
I heard this little voice in my head saying, Tahani, don't do this.
The little voice in your head sounds like the old lady from Downton Abbey.
Oh, yes, sorry. Maggie Smith is my godmother.
But this is hard, because the only trolley I've ever been on is James Franco's ironic trolley. It travels backwards from his penguin grotto to his garage of adult tricycles. There are plenty of other people I could help, like my good friend Ben Affleck and his crippling addiction to back tattoos, or my other good friend Matt Damon and his crippling addiction to my friend Ben Affleck.
Who would you say is the most famous person in your phone?
It's not about who you know. Enlightenment comes from within. The Dalai Lama texted me that.
I once played a drinking game with Ryan Reynolds and Blake Lively at their macrobiotic farm with a particularly robust batch of homemade kombucha.
This really reminds me of my time in Vietnam, picking up mortar shells with my godmother, Diana. Doesn't really matter what she's a princess of, it's not really important.
It really is the most incredible chime I've ever heard. And that is coming from someone whose godfather is the most famous clock in the world.
Is Big Ben somehow your godfather?
Mm-hmm. I haven't encountered this much resistance since I tried to get Timothy Chalamet to go out into the sun.
Remind me to tell you someday about Timothy Chalamet's bar mitzvah.
Absolutely. I feel very confident with you in charge.
In the words of my godfather, acting in what could only be described in hindsight as his most problematic role,
you the man now, dog.
As always, thank you for finding the quickest possible way to say things.
My only real goal was to snog Ryan Gosling at the Met Ball. Which I did. Times, actually.
I haven't been this upset since my good friend Taylor was rudely upstaged by my other friend Kanye, who was defending my best friend, Beyonce.
Tahani is a candidate, as far as I'm concerned. Yesterday, she told me that she was Taylor Swift's best friend, but Taylor Swift wasn't her best friend.
I've been through worse. Once at Elon Musk's birthday party, I was seated between Silvio Berlusconi and Elon Musk.
I suppose a little entrepreneurial spirit never hurt anyone. You know, reach for the stars, as I said to my good friend Elon Musk. And then he shot his car into space.
What a weird creep.
Why was I friends with him?
You know, I once did Trust Falls with Barry Diller, and it was the beginning of a lifelong friendship.
I'm going to tell you the same thing that I told Mark Zuckerberg right before he ousted Eduardo Saverin. You are smart, you are capable, and the time has come to hit unfriend.
I also told Mark to lose the, you know, just Facebook. That was me.
Sure, Ben Affleck told me he'd matured as an artist after he directed Argo, but then, right on schedule, it was, guess what, Tahani? I'm gonna be Batman. That roast was the meanest thing I've ever seen, and I once saw a waiter bring Russell Crowe the wrong tea.
I'm going to tell you the same thing I told Pippa Middleton right before we went paragliding in Gibraltar. Let's go.
It's what I said.
I actually found myself in a very similar situation a few years ago, except in that instance, Michael was Javier Bardem, and the bad place was Vanessa Redgrave's panic room.
I once had a brief fling with a non-famous Hemsworth brother, but even Larry Hemsworth had more status than Jason. I cleansed myself of all the worldly possessions that had been weighing me down, like anchors, the dresses, the jewels. I gave them all to Goodwill. That's what I call Prince William. Since he'd married a commoner, I assumed he'd know some needy people they could go to. In the words of Princess Kate, after we came back from our shopping trip in Ibiza, there's a lot to unpack here. I deleted all my celebrity contacts from my mobile.
Goodbye, Bono. Goodbye, The Edge. Goodbye, The Edge's real phone number that even Bono doesn't have.
That should be fine for me. It's roughly the same size as Nicole Kidman's cryogenic anti-aging chamber, and I've never had a problem in there.
I need you to act as my bodyguard. Like my friend, Kevin Costner, in that movie where he was a bodyguard. The bodyguard.
This money has been a weight around my neck, like the Heart of the Ocean necklace my friend James Cameron once gave me.
Now I have to live next to a man who once lied and said I wasn't at Diddy's white party. I was there, Eleanor, I was. You must believe me.
You two won't be together anymore. I haven't met a more perfect couple since I set up Drake with Ruth Bader Ginsburg.
If you love someone, set them free. A good friend and yoga pupil Sting, no last initial, told me that.
I'm friends with Sting!
Ironically, that's exactly what Vin Diesel asked me when Dwayne Johnson refused to appear in the Fast and the Furious 9. Not helpful?
I'll watch the game with you, Jason.
I enjoy American football. I actually dated a player once, but he wasn't my type, so I set him up with my friend Giselle Bunchen.
How are Chris and Liam and Luke? Sorry, no, I won't mention your brothers again.
I haven't had a pet since Barbara Streisand gave me one of her clone Siamese cats and it killed itself.
This neighborhood that you've built is truly a masterpiece, the likes of which I've never seen, and I've been to Johnny Depp's private bird sanctuary.
You know, sometimes a flaw can make something even more beautiful.
Like with Cindy Crawford and how short she is.
Oh, I was Baz Luhrmann's muse for a while. That was quite fun.
I actually dabbled in a bit of acting after university. Although mostly I just stood around while Baz Luhrmann just threw glitter on me.
Damn, you're good at this.
Well, hang out with Johnny Depp long enough and you become pretty good at lying. Like,
no, your whole thing isn't exhausting at all. You know, I once shoved a hot dog right down the throat of the legendary John Wayne.
She even named Robson Hill.
I'm Tahani Al-Jamil, a vainglorious attention seeker with enough jealousy to power Elon Musk's underwater mansion, which I've been to, by the way.
I have, actually. It's remarkable.
It's remarkable.
To paraphrase a song written by my godfather, hey, Judge, don't make it bad. Take a sad group and make us better.
Quivonjane Wallace and Stephen Hawking in the same room discussing me? Guess they must have made up.
She was the only one who was able to talk me out of that goatee.
Well, I lost that battle with Robert Downey Jr., and I'll be damned if I lose it with you.
We need someone authoritative and reassuring, like Nelson Mandela or Sir Patrick Stewart, or really any of my old racquetball partners would do.
I used to have a breakup routine when a relationship ended. Champagne and Alanis Morissette. Oh, not the actual singer. I'd just listen to her albums at my friend Adele's house.
I had Janet build an exact replica of Victoria Beckham's ultra-exclusive private spa.
I shall go on the attack, just like six of the eight Game of Thrones characters who were based on me would do.
In 2007, Blake Lively invited me to a birthday party held for Leonardo DiCaprio aboard Paul Allen's mega yacht.
I see we're dropping names three at a time now.
The guest list was 100 of the wealthiest, most famous members of the glitterati. Once aboard, I discovered there was a VIP deck, and within that area, there was an even more exclusive room that you could only access with a secret pin, which I promptly entered. And guess who was waiting for me?
I hate to admit it, but I have to know who.
No one. I was the only one there. The party raged on outside, but I was so obsessed with status that I never left. I spent the entire night talking to no one.
Riveting story, if only it were longer and sadder.
I've never had lunch with Mum and Dad. I've only ever stood silently behind their chairs while they ate lobster tail with Oscar De La Renta.
I was once in Portofino with Bruno Mars, LeBron James, and Dr. Ruth Westheimer.
We don't have time for this right now, babe.
Fine. Long story short, LeBron performed a successful tracheotomy, the song won multiple Grammys, and everyone was really happy.
Well, now I want to hear the story.
If I can convince Dr. Ruth not to sue Bruno Mars over songwriting credit on Uptown Funk, I can handle this.
If it would cheer you up, I could tell you what happened at your original funerals. Tahani, Moby spoke first. He claimed that...
Please stop. I don't want to hear it.
I would like to model tonight's event on my most successful gala.
That would be 2006, fundraiser for stem cell research in Barcelona.
Barcelona. Actually. Oh, it was a perfect evening. Princess Stephanie was there, as were Posh and Bex. You know, International Sophisticate magazine gave us 5 Gwyneths.
Carly Kloss did like me. I knew it.
I've already said goodbye to everyone else in my life. My sister, my parents, B&J. I took it very hard.
Don't sell yourself short, Michael. I dare say you're the greatest architect in existence. And I should know. Frank Gehry
is my godfather.
Fair enough. I deserved that.
Once you're a big deal around here, I hope you don't mind if I brag about knowing you.
Name dropping's a little gauche, Michael, but do as you must.